Hey everyone, continuing the series of setting up your own GitLab server inside a Docker container. In this video, I'll show you how to set up GitLab Runner as a container alongside the GitLab server using Docker Compose. If you guys have watched my previous videos on how to set up the GitLab server in a Docker container, we were at the position that we have actually added the GitLab repository. I have added this GitLab demo repository here, and then I've added a GitLab-ci file. But if I go to my pipelines, and if I try to run the pipeline is submitting into the queue. But if we go to the build job, we can see that the build job is stuck. And the reason is we don't have a GitLab runner. And even if we try the CI settings, we don't see any GitLab runner dedicated to the project or any shared runner. And when we try to visit the admin area to look for the shared runners, we don't see any runners here as well. So now if I click on this new instance runner, and I select the default option like the Linux one, I'm adding a test tags. And if I run the create runner, this guy show me some command that we need to run this command to run our GitLab runner. And when we tried this command inside our GitLab server, it was not working. And it says that the GitLab runner command is not found. So this means that we need some other external service, which we call the GitLab runner. And inside that GitLab runner, we can run this command to register our GitLab runner. So if we look at our Docker Compose file, we have the GitLab server. We have some configurations here, and the GitLab server is running on port 8088. So the piece missing here is we need to add another service called GitLab Runner. Images separate than the GitLab server. The GitLab server image is Docker GitLab CE, and the runner image is GitLab Runner. To minimize the download size and to speed up the download, we are using the Alpine version here. But if you guys are okay with the standard versions, you guys can just skip the Alpine here. I'm giving the name GitLab runner to the container. So we will be using the Docker executor to run our pipelines and jobs. So if we go to our CI file, we can see that we are using a Docker image called Python Alpine. And then once that image is loaded and the script is run, we will be just checking which Python version we are using for this Docker image. So to run your pipelines and your jobs inside a Docker container, you need the Docker service, or you need the Docker engine to be running inside your GitLab runner. So to use the GitLab Docker engine inside the GitLab runner, you need to mount your Docker socket file from your host machine to your container, which is the GitLab runner. When you install a Docker in a machine, there are actually two different programs comes in. One is the Docker client and the other is Docker server. So the Docker server actually receives commands over a socket, either over a network or through a file. And the client actually communicates over a network and send messages to the Docker server to make a container, start a container, or stop a container. When the client and the server are running on the same computer, they can connect through a special file called socket. When the Docker client and the Docker server are running on the same computer, they can connect through a special file called socket. And since they can communicate through a file, and Docker can efficiently share files between host and containers, it means you can run client inside Docker itself. The Docker daemon listen for the Docker engine API's request. We have three different types of socket. One is called the Unix, the other is called the TCP, and then the other is FT. By default, a Unix daemon socket is created at this path called var. So if you guys have installed the Docker engine on your host machine, you guys can inspect this file. This is the socket file for Docker through which the Docker client and the Docker server is communicating. So this means that to run and communicate through this socket file from within the GitLab runner to create container and stop container, when we want to execute our jobs, we need to mount or we need to sync this file from our host machine to the Docker container. So for that, I will add another attribute called volumes, and then inside the volumes I'll try to mount this file from my host to the container. So this is the Docker socket file from my host machine, and this will be synced to this file inside the Docker container. Once you add the GitLab service to the Docker Compose file and mount the required Docker socket file, you need to stop your existing GitLab setup. And since we have updated the Docker Compose file for some new changes, we need to do Docker Compose up with --build to actually start building the GitLab runner as well. So after you build the Docker Compose, including the GitLab runner, and you reload the GitLab server, you can go back to this runner section, click on the new instance runner, create the runner. And now this is the command which we need to run inside the GitLab runner container. So I'll go to my terminal. I'll do a docker ps-a to list down all the running containers. This is the GitLab runner container. I'll copy this container ID. I'll try to log into this container. And now I'll go and copy this command, and I'll try to run this command inside the GitLab runner container. So if you guys look at this diagram, this is our host machine. Then we have two containers, one at the GitLab server container, the other one is the GitLab runner. When we are running this command here, GitLab runner register, we are actually running this GitLab runner register command inside this container, which is the GitLab runner container. And once we successfully run this GitLab runner and register command, this will actually create this job executor. It will not create the container after we successfully run this GitLab runner register, but when we actually run our pipeline and the Docker executor, at that time the GitLab runner will actually create another nested container here, which will be actually the executor of that job. So to access the GitLab server like this one from inside this nested executor container, we need to put this container on this host machine networking, because from within the container you can access another container by using the container name. But if you guys notice here, this container is actually on a nested level, it's running inside the GitLab runner. So we need to move up one level to be on the same level as we have the GitLab runner and the GitLab server container. So once we put the networking of this executor container on our host machine, this means that we can access the GitLab server through localhost from within the job executor container. So what I'll add here to this container is that I'll add docker network mode host. This means that add the networking of this docker container on the host machine networking. Now this is asking for the default GitLab instance URL, which is the localhost. So now there are two scenarios. One is when we are running a job inside our docker container, which is the job executor, and this job executor is trying to pull the repository from the GitLab server, then we need to put the docker networking of this container, this executor container, on our host machine. And the other one is when we are registering a runner with the GitLab server. For that you need to put the GitLab runner container, this is also a container, so you need to put the networking of this container on the host machine as well. So if you guys see here, this is the GitLab server, this is the GitLab runner, and we need to put the networking of this container on this host machine networking, because here it needs the GitLab instance URL. Once we complete this command, this will actually, the GitLab runner will actually send all these details to the GitLab server to register this runner. And once that is registered and we want to run our pipelines, this networking will be actually used. So now we have two options here. One is to, since we are communicating between the container to container from the GitLab runner to the GitLab server, one way is to use the container name, which is GitLab server, and then the port name. And the other way is, if you want to use the localhost, you need to put the networking of your GitLab runner container on the host machine as well. For that you need to update your docker compose. You can just add here the network mode to host, and if you add this network mode host, then this means you can use the localhost 8088 here, because since both the containers will be on the same network, they can access each other through localhost. But if you don't want to go into this details, then you need to put the GitLab container name here alongside the port, so the GitLab runner can communicate to the GitLab server when it's trying to register the GitLab runner. Now I'll give it just a dummy name to this runner. To choose an executor, I'll try to run my pipeline jobs inside the docker. So I'll put the docker here. You can select any from these options. And in case you want to provide a default image for this, here I have explicitly mentioned that I'm using the Python image, but if you want to set a default image for this, if I don't set an image here, you can use the default one. So you can set that default image here. So for this I'll use the Python Alpine version, and my GitLab runner is registered. Now what I'll do, that I'll go to my runner sections from the admin area. My GitLab runner is registered here, and if I go to the details, I can see all the details I have provided. So the executor is docker, this is the runner where we have registered our executor. I'll go back to my repository, I'll go to the pipeline section. You guys can see these pipelines have already ran the moment I registered the GitLab runner and the executor here. These jobs were in pending and were already in queue waiting for some executor, so they were already run. But I'll just show you guys again by running a new pipeline. And now if I go to the build stage, and yeah, this pipeline is running with the GitLab runner, and it's using the docker executor image, and the default image is Python Alpine. This has pulled first the docker image for the Python, and here it's actually cloned the repository here, and then it has dumped the Python version, which we have mentioned inside the pipeline, which we have mentioned inside the CI script Python dash version. So that was it for this video. Now if you guys have seen, like, this one is obvious to add the GitLab runner service here and then mount the Docker socket file into the container. But if you guys look at these steps, to first you need to click on this button to create a new instance runner, and then once you create the runner, this will give you a command, and after this you need to log into the GitLab runner container, and then you need to paste this command here and give all the required options. We can also automate this process completely. So the moment we add our GitLab server here and we do a Docker compose up from the command line, we can pass all these options and all these command lines here inside the GitLab runner command. So the moment we actually start up our containers, our GitLab runner will be registered automatically here. So instead of going and generating those commands and running those commands inside the GitLab runner manually, we can also automate this process through the Docker compose file. So in the next video, I'll show you how to automatically register the job executor inside the GitLab runner using Docker compose. So the moment we start our GitLab server and the runner, we will have automatically a runner added here, and the moment we create our pipelines, the jobs inside that pipelines will run automatically. Stay tuned for the next video, and I'll see you in the next video.